get this underway. It's not going to be very long. In fact, it may be less than an hour. In fact, it probably will be less than an hour, depending on the cutscenes, but let's go ahead and head to Bahamut. And it is pronounced Bahamut, not Mutt. It is not a Mutt. It is more than that. Everyone now proceed to select Spring Green. How about not? Although that only matters on the dashboard chat and not the IRC chat, so I can just look at the other one. Roundabout chat, hooray! Cutscene chat, hooray!
This wind, what could it be?
A tornado?
Tornado?
It's headed right for us!
Dear Cid, slain by his son. A common tale of late.
Firing solution complete. Sighting is good. Release valves open. The nether sighters are critical.
Auxiliary show clear.
Put an end to this. They have already surrendered.
Let us make of this an offering. One he might see even now. Vinar? What say you?
The main battery stands ready.
I beg you!
Fire. Once they see that there can be no surrender, the resistance must needs come at us with all they have. We will answer their attack head-on and destroy them before the eyes of all Rabanasta.
If you do this, the people will only grow to hate you the more.
And should I pardon them, they will only rise up yet again.
I do not believe they would. In cooperation lies our hope. You are mistaken. You are wrong, brother.
And if I am? You had best find the strength you need to correct me then.
Ship sighted ahead! A score or more! The resistance fleet, my lord!
Hear this! Today we write the first page of a new history. Our history. Each of you must play his part. Put down this rebellion. For Arcadia, we fight!
For Arcadia!
May fortune favor us all.
This is Auto 3 here. Keep the formations tied. Give them a warm welcome. Many more to choose from. Fight for the taken.
Give word to the cannons. Make ready and fire.
We have a clean line.
Prepare the second volley. Be quick. By the gods.
She's lost. Unknown ship from aback.
Could it be?
Uncle, it is I. I'm crossing to the Bahamut to stop Vane.
What are you saying? You are too rash. Your duties come after the battle is over.
If we allow them to destroy us here, there will be no after. You must assist our charge.
Stop! You must pull back. Stop the stall!
Hold it! I mean, wait! This is Larsa Solidor. I'm going in with her, so we're fine. I got the princess covered.
Larsa Solidor? So you hold him as a hostage?
No, Uncle. He will fight with us against Vane. Leave it to us.
Understood. Our fate is in your hands.
Yes.
I got the princess covered.
Larson, say that. We're relying on you for fire support. Give him something to think about. We'll pick our moment and make our move. Vane will be in the fortress's command tower. I saw something of the like on our way in here. Right above our heads.
That treasure chest.
We need not fight all the Empire to win. If we can get to Vane, we can put an end to this war.
Let's get going then. Find Vayne wherever he's perched and knock him off.
LP2 is your favorite. What's up with this party? This party is not right at all. Not that it matters at this level, but hey. What the heck is LP2? Also, why is there a treasure chest here? I don't recall this being here. Gives you dark matter. Suppose you could use that. And of course, this has the same style map as the crystal, which means you don't get a map. Anyone know any interesting games to watch? I don't know. I know interesting people to watch. This entire scenario is gonna be really easy. Kind of because I'm about 40 levels higher than I should be, so we're probably gonna like two-shot the boss or something ridiculous. These are the gambits I've been using for Ultima and Zodiac and stuff like that, so if we get killed by him, that'd be quite the surprise. LP2 equals Lost Planet 2. I don't really like Lost Planet, or Lost Planet 2, or Lost Planet 3. Not a fan of it. There's another chest with an elixir in it. Ooh. If you're doing this fight on level, or these fights, as it were, you're probably going to want to use multiple elixirs, maybe even a mega elixir, or two if you have them. Mega elixirs are pretty rare, though, so... In fact, I think I may have already used my mega elixir. Yeah, I used the mega elixir I had. Probably during Zodiac. Where am I going? Supposed to be in here, I think. There's, like... three, maybe four boss fights? I can't remember exactly. It's where everyone lives.
The Resistance fights their battle well. We dare not fail them. We dare not falter.
Stop worrying. We just have to clean up here, and then Ash will be the queen.
It's kind of hard to believe. I can't even imagine trying to rule a whole kingdom.
A queen might always run away with the help of a sky pirate looking to raise his bounty a peg.
I doubt our queen would need the help of any sky pirates.
Do you really think me as strong as all that?
Who said anything about strong? You'll make it. You got good friends.
Yay, friendship. Know any others that are interesting? I like Over the Gun, although it can be kind of irritating because he's Fail Incarnate. Epic Name Bro, if you're a fan of the Souls series and games related to the Souls series. Let's see, you already have Plump, Avac, Jeff, Revocaine, Grimmoth. Oh yeah, there's these things, which are annoying as heck. They're probably the most difficult enemy you'll fight here, because they cause status ailments and they have a pretty large amount of health. And there's a variety of them, obviously, as you can see. Certain rooks are more difficult than other ones. The sphere ones just kind of float around like an idiot. We need to go over here, though. I would have to look at... my subs to actually find some more. SSOH PKC is alright. It's not great. It's alright though. It's one of the few like major channels that I can actually watch. A mushroom pizza. I don't like mushrooms. Mushrooms are nasty. Also, first boss fight.
So you have lived.
I am Judge Magister. Even in disgrace, my just reward for aiding the Empire that destroyed my homeland.
Gabranth, do not blame yourself anymore.
You confound me, brother. You failed Landis. You failed Damaska. All you were to protect. Yet you still hold on to your honor. How?
I had someone important to defend. And defender I have. How is it that you have survived? Is it not because you defend Lord Larsa?
Silence! All was stripped from me. Only hatred for the brother who fled our homeland remains mine. Tell me, why did you forsake that which you must hold most precious?
I do as I must, brother. Or is that not answer enough?
This is exactly like the last time you fought him. He has slightly more health. He starts with haste. He uses sentence, which does basically nothing. He will start blocking and chaining constantly when he gets about half health.
Your friends die, as they must, for surely you cannot protect them. Know now the despair you have taught me.
Even on level, this fight is extremely easy. When he hits half health, he uses renew and he'll start. It's basically the same fight, except he'll chain more. You'll start using this, which is, again, same thing we've seen before. It's just a different animation. It does the same thing as his other attack. It's not a hard fight, even on level, so. And then he uses Enrage. There you go. This is the point where the fight becomes really difficult on level, because that chain will kill people. So you might have to use some Phoenix Downs or some high-level magic at that point in the fight to finish him off quickly.
Have you your fill of this?
I would ask you the same. Let this end, Noah.
I have no right to be called by that name.
Then live and reclaim it.
I like the music choice during this part. Did we actually ride the elevator up? Or did we just not push the button yet? I don't remember. So sad. Yeah, we didn't actually ride up. So very sad. The hard part of this, obviously, as is logical, is actually the last fight, because that dude will wipe your entire party multiple times if you're on level for the fight.
I bid you welcome to my sky fortress, the Bahamut. I must apologize for my delay in welcoming you aboard my ship. Permit me to ask,
who are you? An angel of vengeance? Or perchance a saint of salvation?
I am simply myself. No more and no less. And I want only to be free.
Such a woman is not fit to bear the burden of rule. Weep for Dalmasca, for she is lost. Observe well, Larsa. Watch and mark you, the suffering of one who must rule, yet lacks the power.
No. No, brother. I will not. Though I lack your power, I will still persist.
Bold words, child.
Lord Larsa.
If I recall, this has two stages. The first stage is a fairly simple sit here and beat on him stage, which we just completed in about 2 seconds.
Your lives are forfeit, and your insurgents with them. Dalmasca will again know order. For good and all, I shall bring your futile attempts at rebellion to an end.
Good job, team.
What am I to do with those who would oppose me?
At some point, he summons swords or something, I think, which are incredibly annoying. Pretty sure it's after we completely remove his health bar. The first half of this fight is not too bad because he can't chain like the last guy can. What you have to worry about is his specials like this, which hit pretty hard. They hit so hard he broke the universe. As you can see, even though we're 40 levels above him, that still hit us for 2k, so that can wipe your party if you don't have too much health. Recommended you have Bubble. Although you should have Bubble at this point in the game, so have at least one person with Bubble on.
Lord Brother!
Larsa!
Now comes the slightly harder part of this fight.
Manufactured Nethersite.
I will defend Lord Larsa.
The hound strays. Treason bears a price.
One I gladly pay.
And no, he didn't gain 40 levels to make this interesting. The thing with this fight, he hits pretty hard, but the main thing is the swords. You can target every one of the swords. Every one of the swords can take individual actions, and they will very quickly murder you. If you can, try to wait for all of the swords to be somewhat near him. It's not going to be a hard fight for us. Try to make for the swords to be near him. And blow a quickening chain on him.
We are their puppets no more. The freedom for which we have longed is at hand.
He will bring the swords back, but a quickening chain should do some good damage to him, and if not kill the swords, because I don't know how much health they have. If not kill the swords, they will at least highly damage the sword. Like, right now would be a good point to do it. Apparently... Oh, that's just Ash dispelling things. I thought she was casting Cure on them for some reason. Like they were undead or something. He's an ugly Fabio. Hooray! He's got some cool abilities, I'll give him that much. I mean, you can't go wrong if you can do this. Thankfully, it doesn't hit very much. The real damage in this fight is mostly from the swords, really. There we go. He doesn't do a whole lot. He very slowly attacks. Kind of sits there and floats around.
I like how polite we are to the undying. We just kindly wait for them to move.
Bosh, tell me. He is a good master? Aye.
Hi, Dean. I didn't say hello as well because it was during a cutscene, if I recall. Are there a lot of people using pink? I don't see anyone using pink. Kasha's using purple. I don't see a lot of pink, though.
I have failed us both. I am no Dynast King. You must find another. One who might realize your ambitions.
They are fulfilled beyond your knowing.
The Christ is sundered. Age of Stones complete. From the Undying Ones, the world is freed. You shall not tread this path alone. Together we go. Come.
Dean is showing up as light green. Whatever color that is.
Won't Cid be eager to learn what has happened here? History begins anew.
Because that's what you do when you have unlimited power. You make yourself into what? And then it immediately starts the fight with the Undying, who has haste. This is a pretty tricky fight, primarily because he knows really powerful abilities. I do have every summon. I don't think I gave people every summon. We have Ultima. I don't think I gave anyone Zodiac. Let me see if there's just a Zodiac sitting somewhere that I can give to someone. Unless maybe I did give someone Zodiac, I'm not entirely sure. It looks like I may have. That's Exodus. Is it you? You have Zalera. You have Zodiac. Bosh! Can I summon you? Or use you? We'll swap Ash out for a second. Quite frankly, just because I can. You'll notice he has no health bar. He has a lot of hit points. It's a very long fight, especially on level. We're gonna just murder him because we're level 97, but I might drag the fight out artificially just to show you some stuff. So here's Zodiac using Banish Ray, which is gonna do a whole lot of nothing. I primarily summoned him so we could show off Final Eclipse, which is his perfect move, or final ability, or whatever you want to call it. Normally, you have to do some convoluted series of events to get him to use this, but because we can control summons, we can just tell him to use it. This will boot him out, so it's basically three mischarges for a fairly good attack, to be honest. Zodiac is weird. I'm just saying, a little bit weird. Welcome to Zodiac version 2. This hits like a truck, by the way, if you can't tell. It hits like a truck. It really does. It will murder things. It hit him for 60,000 damage, which is, I'm pretty sure, almost all of his health. So, let's turn off our gambits for a second. He's gonna pop Mega Flare, which is the main damage dealer. Hits pretty hard. I would like to swap Bosch back out, because he's done. We could summon... Who has Ultima? Let's just summon things. Let me find out who has Ultima real quick. I wish there was an easy... Oh wait, no, we already know. Knight Vaughn has it, so... We'll just sit here like this for a while. See if we can get him to use some abilities. Ow. All of his magic, by the way, is piercing, which means it pierces magic defense and does more damage. It doesn't fully pierce magic defense, but he chains them. So, he's a pretty tricky fight. Even up to level, probably the high 60s, low 70s, he can be pretty hard to deal with. And yes, we are healing 8k on a Cura. We don't even need to use Kiraha, it heals like 15k or something ridiculous. You want to use an ability, dude. Piercing Thundaga? That's just thunder. I can do this all day, man. Literally do this all day. And let's just go ahead and summon Ultima. Ultima also hits like a truck, but not quite as much of a truck as Zodiac. Zodiac is the final summon, and he has a very hard, very difficult to trigger his final attack in the normal version. Obviously not so much now, when I can just tell them to use it. You, technique. Eschathon, Eschathon, Eschathon? I'm not entirely sure. I don't actually know how to pronounce that. Ultima is Zodiac's opposite, so they both have very cool-looking final move things. Hers is an ion cannon. You granted like I was at a brothel when you weren't here. That was off, like, off camera, off livestream or whatever. It was just me grinding constantly. Ow. You want to use an ability at some point? We may not have actually gotten him to half health, because he hasn't even triggered really anything yet. So let's have people just hit him for a while. Chain magic, okay. We got a little bit of his health off then. He will give himself buffs periodically throughout the fight, and barriers periodically throughout the fight, so... You'll have to swap how you're attacking him. There we go. That's what I was waiting for. I wish we could see his health bar, but it looks like he's actually... Is he crit? Hold on. Turn off gambits for a second. No, he's not crit yet. He's just gone into more buff phase. Just use Libra? He doesn't have health. You can't see his health. It's impossible. Now it's immune to physical. Alright, well. Giga Flare! I was using all the abilities I was trying to get him to use. There is no way, apart from cheating, to tell what his health is. Good job blowing up your own ship, dude. Jeez. So rude. That is his Party Wipe ability, by the way. If you are about level 65, it'll probably kill your whole party. So make sure you have a backup party that's at least level 40-ish, so they can get some revives off. Whenever you're done being invulnerable. I guess I could swap Pinello in. Just for funsies, let's fire a laser at him. I could probably poison him. Or HP sap. Well, actually, probably not. 9.3k. And then Pinello died. But still, 9.3k. Should probably debuff him. If we can. Probably could. That's generally why I don't use Scathe, by the way, because you can't do anything during its animation, so. Just. Can you try to dispel him or something? I know you want to buff us, but. And there's perfect defense right after I do that, so. Time for you to stop existing, because you're not going to do anything. You're just going to waste MP. And it's going to use Giga Flare again. I don't know if this is magic or physical. I assume it's physical, but... could be magic, so I don't know if Shell or Protect defend against it. Or if it's piercing. Who knows? Most of his other crap is piercing. Conscious back. Hooray. He's actually in crit, yeah, because he used his perfect shield. The shield lasts for a predetermined amount of time, and it happens right as he goes in crit. So basically, get out your healers. Two of them, preferably. I already have two healers, so we can just kind of chill here. And you basically just have to wait out his invulnerability. Because you can't hit him. You can't damage him in any way, shape, or form. So you just have to survive until he's done doing this. Which, again, is a party wipe mechanic. He has... yep, there he goes. Now he's gonna piercing Holy, and this is the point in the fight where it becomes very annoying, because you can't heal during Holy. Piercing Dispelga. He's actually very, very hard to kill once he gets to crit. At this point, you're probably going to start blowing, say, any haste motes or haste dagas you have available. Chuck dispel motes if he still has buffs. Ethers, elixirs, pretty much everything. Just use it at this point. Because Holy, if you're... and there he goes. If you're on level, Holy will kill whoever it targets. We are not on level, so we can just tank it like that, the slow boat way.
Well, can we fly?
No fuel goes to the Glossair engines.
Damn. Vaughn, you're in charge. I'm checking the engine room.
Right.
Fran, with me.
Look! Bahamut's Glossair rings are stopping!
Vaughn, as soon as the Strahl's rings move, you take off. Understood? You can fly her, Vaughn. Just do it like I told you.
Don't worry.
Pinello, watch for interference from Bahamut's Skystone. The Strahl's a fickle girl. You keep her working for us.
I'll see what I can do.
Bosh, look after Lhasa, will you? If House Solidor should crumble, the Empire would fail, and civil war would take us all.
I understand.
The Lord Lhasa is our last hope.
Vaughn, the power's back. We can go.
Right. Let's go. Grab onto something.
Sir, it's the Strahl. She's left Bahamut. She's moving away.
The Strahl. They made it. At last. The Bahamut has fallen. The final test is upon us. The judges shall rule us no more. Main cannon on the Alexander.
This is Judge Magister Gabon. All quarters cease fire. I repeat, all units of the Arcadian army, hold your fire.
The battle is over. As of this moment, we have signed a ceasefire with the Shelia Benargan Delmasca, her Royal Majesty.
Attention, this is Lhasa Farinus Solidor.
My brother Vane has died with honor in battle. The Imperial fleet is now under my command.
Sir, your orders, sir.
This is Ashelia Delmasca.
The Lady Ash, thank the gods you live.
I confirm what Judge Magister Gabranth and Lhasa Solidor have said here.
Please stand down your attack. The war is over. Ivalice looks to the horizon.
A new day has dawned. We are free. Bahamut!
A message from the Alexander.
Take it,
sir.
This is Judge Sargabath, captain of the Alexander, flagship of the 12th Damascan fleet of the Arcadian army.
I address all ships in Rabanaster's airspace. The Bahamut must not be allowed to fall on the city of Rabanaster.
We are preparing to ram her. Do not interfere.
Madness.
Should she fall, the paling will not hold,
and all Rabanaster will be obliterated. All ships, concentrate your fire on the Alexander's remains once Bahamut is clear of the city.
Hasty, aren't they? I think it's a little early to be throwing away our lives just yet.
Balthier? Wait! Balthier, where are you?
Oh, Vaughn. Sounds like you made it out okay. The Strahl's a fine airship, eh?
What does he think he's doing? Balthier!
Marquis, stop that fool judge on the Alexander for me, would you? Just getting somewhere with these Glossair rings. Almost done. Don't want him ramming me before I fix them, do we?
Balthier, do you understand exactly what it is you're doing?
Princess! No need to worry. I hope you haven't forgotten my role in this little story. I'm the leading man. You know what they say about the leading man? He never dies. Let's fly! Fran, power to the Glossair rings. Fran?
everything around here.
Listen to me, Balthier. Get out of Bahamut immediately.
Please, Balthier. You mustn't die.
Please, Balthier. Come back.
Yeah. I'd say you're in more of a supporting role.
Fran, please.
Vaan, the Strahl's in your hands. You'd better take care of her, you hear? If there's one scratch on her when I get back.
Roger that. We'll be waiting for you.
Balthier!
It's hard to believe a year has passed so quickly. Rabanaster is finally back to the way it was, like when my parents were still alive. We've lost so much, but I think it's important to put the past behind us and keep our eyes on the road ahead. Coronation is next month. She grows farther and farther away from us, but I guess that's how it has to be. She is queen now, after all. I am looking forward to seeing you at the ceremony.
You called, my lord.
To Arcades, to further the cause of peace in Ivalice. But still, I hope he comes back to Rabanaster and Ash soon. She has to keep up appearances now, so she would never say it, but I think she misses him.
Lose Lhasa, and we lose the Empire. Protect him. I would entrust him to no other's care.
I will keep him from harm. I promise you, for the Empire and for Dalmasca.
Your words, Bumiri's brother. Sorry to leave you.
As time goes by, I know you'll see. Miss of me. I haven't told you the most important part. Vaughn and I had been taking care of the Strahl, but it was stolen. We had just finished having her tuned up, too. Actually, stolen might not be the right word. If her owner wants her back, there's not much we can do about it, is there? So Vaughn's going to pay the two of them a visit. You should see him. He can hardly wait. I'll be going too, of course. Every good sky pirate needs a partner, right?